I had seen the fact that people are from varied industries. So, and I see that a lot of engineering, you know, people are not on this particular webinar. So what we can talk about is, we can talk about the application of artificial intelligence in our everyday lives. How is it impacting our lives? The second area that we could also talk about is how can you personally, each one of you, wherever you are, in whichever industries that you are, how can you apply artificial intelligence to your life, to your businesses? Some of you are business owners, some of you are managing different business functions, and some of you are managing other aspects in life. So how can you apply different aspects of artificial intelligence in your lives and work on an everyday basis? And the third area is how can you actually make some value being created intelligence and the tools of today and the tools of tomorrow. How can it enrich you? How can you make some money using AI? I think these are majorly three broad categories that we could just classify and see where all do we apply, you know, wherever artificial intelligence stands today.
Great. So this sounds very exciting. I mean, if you tell everyday use and you tell functional use, then what else do you need? Looking forward.
Yeah. Shefali, let me know whenever we want to start.
So I think, Kunal, we are already 26 and few people are on the way, they are joining. So respecting each other's time, I propose that we should start and people will gradually join us.
Sure. Just give me one second. Let me just see how can I just start the PPT here.
I have given you the screen sharing option and I'll just give a small brief introduction and then you can start.
Sure. Let's just do that.
So can I start with my part of speaking?
Please.
Sure. Go. Thank you. So good evening, everyone. Namaskar. I, Shefali Sangal from Young Minds, welcome you all to this special evening of Artificial Intelligence, AI. Our intelligence is what makes us human, and artificial intelligence is an extension of that quality. Few years back, we hardly knew artificial intelligence. And today it has taken such a place in our daily life that we can't imagine a life without artificial intelligence. So today we have with us Mr. Kunal Gupta, founder and CEO, Mount Talent Consulting Private Limited, Value Innovation Labs, and Rosegar.com. Kunal is a first generation entrepreneur. He is a speaker, an economist, and an investor. He has founded 7 companies in multiple business domains, including HR tech, employment, information technology, digital marketing, staffing.
So,
I was telling about the organizations which Kunal has been taking care of, his initiatives. That is, the domains include more of HR tech, employment, information technology, digital marketing, staffing, consulting, infrastructure. He was recently awarded Philip Kotler's prestigious Iconic Award, the Emerging CEO of the Year Award, and also has been awarded and honored by Chief Minister of Haryana State, Shri Manohar Lal Khattar, with Industry Integrated Employment Promotions. So he, on and on, he has been a AI, you know, lover guy. He has been doing a lot of activities around AI. And his initiative, Shaheed Ki Beti, a technology-driven initiative, has been recognized by a president of India. So huge round of applause to Mr. Kunal Gupta. Kunal, I welcome you all. I welcome you to this special evening and thank you so much for accepting our request to be an honorary speaker today. And now over to you. We would like to listen from you. Thank you so much. So Kunal, we over to you. We are waiting for you.
The presentation, and I'll share this presentation link with everybody, and maybe during and after the presentation we'll just go through it. The idea of artificial intelligence is not of today. Artificial intelligence has been around for almost about the last 70 years as we speak to make systems and businesses more intelligent over the years has been a quest which led to the invention of computers and so on and so forth. When we say artificial intelligence, what fundamentally do we mean by it? We understand that humans have connects with objects and people. And at the same time, when we talk about machines, there are machines which have hardware. It's a combination of electronics and a combination of few set of chips and so on and so forth. When we look at making machines more intelligent and how we apply that intelligence into our relationship with humans, other humans and other objects is where artificial intelligence gets formulated. Now, artificial intelligence is everywhere, wherever we see right now. I mean, we look at, say right now our phones have something called face recognition technologies. Now, face recognition technology is again a form and a part of AI. We talk about self-driving cars. Self-driving cars are again a form and shape of where artificial intelligence is being used. You use something called a Google engine. Now, Google is which currently uses possibly some of the finest forms of AI, both in terms of imaging, video, and the most important of everything, which is called natural language. Now, NLP has been one of the hardest problems to solve. I remember, majority of my time in college, when I was studying engineering, went on majorly two areas. One is the speech to text and the text to speech form. And second is the form wherein we recognize objects through something called computer vision. Today this science has advanced in such a manner that you can draw out inferences and multiple kinds of behavioral patterns and drive on how you and I get impacted on an everyday basis by all means using data which has been collated over a period of time, which drives into what behavior we show towards multiple objects and how and what objects are relevant to us over a period of time. Now, whether it is your choices on music, whether it is your choices on buying something in a retail store, whether it is about your choices about how you socialize, what colors you wear, there are some programs and there are enough software companies which collate data of all these kinds everywhere. Starting from your Alexa, Alexa this, Alexa that, Alexa play this song, Alexa what is the weather. Now, you may think that Alexa is like, it's a wow technology. But, there has been at least 25 years of research from 1993, which has gone into creating Alexa or Google Assistant what it is today. You talk about self-drive cars. The efficiency of self-drive cars is still, is questionable by some people, but it is way better than about 90-95% of driving behavior of a lot of drivers across the globe. And that has been proven by a long way. Now, majorly when we talk about artificial intelligence, there are three major areas that we talk about in artificial intelligence. One is something wherein we look at how data is collated. Data is collated in all forms, all shapes, all the time. You have strong predictive analytics, which helps in using and making all the data which is collated on an everyday basis, whether from your mobile phones, from your laptops, from your everyday moving around, on how Google Maps collates your data, and then shows back the trends with which you envisage your next level of decision making through it. In the meantime, so while the screen doesn't get put up, I would like to answer your question, and it would be very nice to have an interactive session while we talk, and I could just share about my experiences and about how we create AI and businesses. So we will jump to those slides first, and then we will look at implications and case studies of AI in many different areas. There are some examples that I was talking about, whether it is in terms of autopilot or auto-driven cars, whether it is in terms of natural language processing systems, which we see in terms of how voice-to-text or text-to-speech works. Now, voice-to-text and text-to-speech may just appear very simple to you, but imagine ordering a voice assistant, a Google or an Alexa, Alexa, order a pizza for me. Or Google Assistant, can you call this person for me? If in case those of you who use Siri, I use Siri a lot on my iPhone, and I directly order, hey Siri, can you call Anand? And Siri calls Anand. I hope it doesn't dial in right now. But that's the way these voice assistants are working. And now the actual implication of these guys, of these technologies, are going to be for a lot of people who do not understand software. All you fortunate people, you have had the, the fortune of learning English. You have had the fortune of learning computers. And you are able to apply that knowledge in being here with each other right now over a Zoom call. But a lot of other people have possibly not been as fortunate. Now for them, you know, when a painter goes to buy a paint or when somebody goes to buy something in the market, he can just order it and he can get it. So like somebody doesn't know how to book a cab via Ola, he can just use his voice. Hindi mein bol sakta hai. Hindi mein bol sakta hai, Kannad mein bol sakta hai, Malayalam mein bol sakta hai, Marathi mein bol sakta hai. पहली बात तो आपका जो AI है, आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, वो इंजन है जो ये बताता है कि जो व्यक्ति जो भाषा का प्रयोग कर रहा है वो कौन सी लैंग्वेज में कर रहा है. हिंदी में बोल रहा है, मराठी में बोल रहा है, बंगाली में बोल रहा है. पहला आपका सिस्टम ये जान पाए कि आपकी लैंग्वेज डिटेक्शन क्या है. दूसरा आपकी लैंग्वेज के बेसिस पे किसी भी रैंडम इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट पे वो एक्शन ले सके. इसको ट्रैवर्स करना बड़ा ही मुश्किल काम है. इसको अगर हम रोजमर्रा की जिंदगी में देखेंगे तो इट इज बेसिकली एन एरिया विच इज ट्रांसफॉर्मेटिव इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाउ अवर लाइव्स आर गोइंग टू स्पैन आउट ओवर द नेक्स्ट फ्यू इयर्स. We also look at one of the largest case studies in this area, which is called the smart homes. How our homes are connected. You walk into one room, the lights get switched on. You walk off the room, the lights get switched off. Your car goes to the parking lot, your AC gets switched on. You can schedule anything and everything at your home based on your behavioral patterns. Before you walk in from the parking lot to your drawing room is already accommodated itself to a temperature which is suitable to your body temperature. Thanda kar deta hai kamra apne aap before you come in to your room. There are these, AI has reached a level wherein your babies can actually be sleepwalked by cradlers, jo apne aap ek bacche ko ek aisi feeling de dete hain such that bacche ko ghumaya ja raha hai. You know, so AI has gone to a level wherein flower pots can currently measure what is the level of water which is there in these flower pots. Your cycles can actually measure how much calories you're losing, what all ways you want to lose calories. Your learning systems have gone so efficient. Netflix is intelligent enough now. You will be surprised if, in case for those of you who do not know, that aajkal ye jo series aap content dekhte hain Netflix pe, Amazon Prime pe, a lot of stories, a lot of content is actually written using analytics ki logo ko kitne proportion mein कॉमेडी पसंद है, कितने प्रोपोर्शन में एक्शन पसंद है, कितने प्रोपोर्शन में आइडियलिज्म पसंद है. आई विल जस्ट ट्राई टू टच अपॉन वन ऑफ द सीरीज विच इज कॉल्ड सूट्स. इट इज सपोज टू बी अ बिजनेस सीरीज एंड मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द कॉन्टेंट इज रिटन कीपिंग द प्रोटैगनिस्ट जो हीरो है उस स्टोरी का, हार्वी स्पेक्टर, उसको एक बहुत ही अच्छे मॉरल का, हाई मॉरल का, क्लीन ऑनेस्ट आदमी दिखाया गया है, क्योंकि लोगों को वही देखना पसंद आता है. So, लोगों को अगर देखना आता है, so that is what is being shown in these series, and that is how the series are customized such that your experience of the content is possibly the best. Like, you can just go to the next slide, and we can just run through the next 4-5 slides in one shot. Now, this is where some of these technology stacks are being used right now. Chandra, if in case the session is not useful for you, maybe you can just, I can possibly do a one-to-one conversation with you some other time. And if in case it is not making great sense for you, we could just take on the session some other time. I can schedule a call with you. But for others, let's just run through what all technologies do we use. So Python is typically used for something called automation tools in terms of, you see a lot of these advertisement messages which come from WhatsApp to you. You see a lot of these automatic messages which come for advertising, a lot of these places wherein you get push messages on your Bluetooth and so on and so forth. So Python writes a lot of automated scripts for sending messages and stuff and so on and so forth. TensorFlow is typically used for imaging. And if in case we look at the AI trends, we are looking at how much money each country is making, and America is at the forefront. Neeraj, if in case we can go to the second slide, the slide before this. Neeraj, the slide before that, the second slide only. Yeah, revenues from AI in the American market only. Now, as per an McKinsey estimate, there are about 2.5 crore jobs, 2.4 million jobs, 2.5 crore jobs, which are typically going to get redundated by the usage of AI. Now, what does it really mean? That is AI going to take your job? Not really. You know, if in case we have heard this story over the last 100 years that industrialization has killed people, jobs, and so on and so forth. However, it hasn't really happened that way. There are going to be new jobs which are going to be created with times which are going to change. Obviously, as the industry progresses, the quality of jobs is also going to change. We can go to the next slide, Neeraj. Now, which all industries are largely going to be impacted with the use of AI? Now, why is retail going to be impacted the maximum? I'll just like to take some time in basically looking at the first three areas on where the industries are getting the most impacted. Now, the first industry which gets most impacted is retail. Now, retail is a combination of where you use a lot of predictive analytics in your decision making to happen. Your buying behavior, your shopping behavior, your consumer profiling, aapko kis tarike ke packages diye jaate hain, what kind of bundled options do you get? So it's a very famous old case of Tesco selling diapers along with beers. So Tesco realized that if in case they put beer bottles next to the diapers, so people who come in and shop in the afternoon and the evening times are more likely to buy that. Now that's a very small use case of how bundling happens. A similar case is also used in the online publishing industry by as large companies as Economist as well, wherein how they bundle the print packages and the web and print packages as well. So in retail, based on your behavioral patterns, what colors you like, what kind of sizes and shapes do majority people like, by doing enough data collection about people, retail industry designs better quality products. They define and redefine fashion over a period of time. If in case you've seen some soothing colors which have changed now over the last 20 years, on the kind and quality of colors which you used to see about 10 years back or 20 years back to the kind and quality of colors that we see now, has required a lot of image oriented natural language data processing which has gone into it. What colors actually soothe you? If in case you guys have heard of something called user experience, how do people stay connected onto screens? Now, when you see the font sizes of even this presentation, these font sizes are very, very rounded. They create a very nice soothing experience as compared to the Arial and the Calibri or the other fonts that, or Times New Roman, which you might have been using over many years. Now, you may or may not realize, but this font size also has a huge impact in terms of how you experience this entire data which is presented in front of you. How many minutes can you spend in front of the slide? Transportation and logistics industry have obviously been impacted greatly and immensely. The cost of transportation is today possibly 1/10. Imagine 1/10 the cost of logistics and transportation in the last 25 years when it comes to per capita cost for moving of goods and stuff. Travel industry, you have a lot of engines like Make My Trip, Ibibo. You see a lot of ads from any of these companies in terms of personalized travel packages or overall travel packages. What all places of destination do you like to go and so on and so forth. We can just run through a host of these sectors, but we can just move to the next slide. What business domains typically, which business domain will make money in AI? Now, when we say business domains, we really need to understand the first sentence with which I started. AI is basically going to map out your relationship between human and objects. Ultimately, दो ही चीजें हैं कि आपका एक आदमी का रिलेशनशिप अलग अलग ऑब्जेक्ट से क्या होता है और एआई मशीन जो मशीन होती है क्या वो मशीन ह्यूमन को अलग कर सकती है और क्या वो ऑब्जेक्ट को उसके सिंबल के अनुसार उसके आइकन्स के अनुसार डिफ्रेंशिएट कर सकती है अपने आप या नहीं कर सकती और उसके आधार पे आप या तो अपने आप रूल्स बना सकते हैं जो आपकी इंडस्ट्री के लिए सूटेबल है या फिर आप ऐसे रूल्स बना सकते हैं जो बनी बनाई कंपनीज आपको देती हैं. We can come to that question also, Nepal Singh, in terms of how AI is applied in bank. We have one of those use cases covered in this presentation as well. Now, contract analysis is very important. Contract analysis is a very important area. Now, why is contract analysis very important is because in the current corporate world, it is typically a relationship between a buyer and a supplier and how AI typically influences those. Object detection, like I said, object detection navigation is possibly one of the major areas, which is something that has improved over many years. And this is again one area which is going to go a long way. It is about how the machines recognize the colors, the patterns, the objects. How do they understand the tags? How do they understand the icons? Ab ek maan lijiye self-driving car hai. Agar wo self-driving car ka camera detect nahi kar payega ki uske samne kya object hai. और उसको कैसे यूज करना है, कैसे क्लासिफाई करना है, क्या वो सही है, क्या वो गलत है, तो वो चल नहीं पाएगा. टेक्स्ट क्वेरी, आप इमेजेस सर्च करते हैं, इमेजिन योर मशीन इज इंटेलिजेंट इनफ टू थ्रो बैक व्हाट रिजल्ट इज मोस्ट यूजफुल फॉर यू, वेदर इट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ इमेजेस और वेदर इट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ सर्च क्वेरीज दैट यू सेंड ऑन गूगल. So these are some of the business domains and some of the application areas, whether it is about marketing and services areas, supply chain areas. रिस्क कैसे कम हो सकता है आपका, स्टैटिक इमेज रिकॉग्निशन. अब आज के डेट में यू हैव एआई व्हिच कैन टेल यू, इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक. एंड एआई एल्गोरिथम कैन टेल यू कि आपके फ्रिज में कौन कौन सी सब्जी रखी हुई है, फ्रूट रखा हुआ है, क्या वो खत्म हो गया, क्या वो खत्म नहीं हुआ है. इफ इन केस योर स्टॉक ऑफ इन्वेंट्री ऑफ एप्पल हैज रिड्यूस्ड और यू नो और एनीथिंग हैज रिड्यूस्ड, your system can automatically order with an API integration with Amazon and have and request for an order to be fulfilled via Amazon if in case your stock is getting limited. So based on the fact that you know you can order and you can customize your algorithms that your stock of apple should never finish or your stock of onion should never finish, so AI can intelligently order by itself the stock can reach you, and the stock can reach you through drones as well. Now we move to the next slide. So before I end that slide, so marketing and sales is the single biggest application area wherein AI is largely used. Aap sab jagah ads dekhte hain, Facebook pe ads dekhte hain, Google pe ads dekhte hain, sab jagah ads dekhte hain. Ads ki customization badi important hai. Based on what you might have been currently looking at, what you might have been currently searching, uske basis pe hi aapko ads aate hain. Neeraj, we move to the next slide, please. What are the nations? So why do you see a lot of these Western countries as one of the most biggest drivers for AI? One is unke yahan na need bahut bada hai AI ka. The reason is number of people in these countries are very less and the cost of hiring humans is very high. As compared to the Asian world, as compared to the Asian countries of both China and India, wherein the cost of hiring people is possibly proportionally very, very less of employing and utilizing an algorithm or a product for conducting and doing basic things. A lot of countries in the Western world find it extremely difficult to identify people to do the daily task. So what they have done is they have automated all the basic functions. Ab jaise aap dekhte hain aaj ki date mein aap, so what you are seeing and experiencing today after 5 years in terms of chatbots helping you solve queries, whether it is on Big Basket or whether it is about banks or any other popular areas, these countries have already adopted it, because if in case they end up hiring one BPO executive, it costs them nothing less than about $30,000, which is about 20 lakh rupees for hiring one BPO executive who helps you solve your queries, and you're still not going to be happy enough if in case your queries are being solved. So automatically, ek to need based hai. Second is obviously the quality of education in these countries has been fairly advanced as compared to India. And fortunately, they have been able to create more advances in terms of sciences as well as technology to get to this stage. Neeraj, we move to the next slide, please. Which AI sub technologies? I think this is an area we can dwell on, but if in case somebody wants to technically connect over it, we can have a technical session. But I'll just briefly tell you about AI, machine learning. So a lot of people collapse AI with machine learning as well. Now, machine learning is a key to achieve artificial intelligence. Ultimately, artificial intelligence is a pseudo term. It is a set of instructions which make a machine learn by itself, machine function for itself. And basically, AI tak pahunchne ke liye machine learning or deep learning, dono ke dono hi bahut badi badi sciences hain. Deep learning is basically researching about one area, you know, in depth in terms of getting more detail into it. There are some otherwise regression analysis and then analytics and data collection methods, and there are multiple areas in terms of linear classifiers that you see on the right hand side. which enable AI to be reached. But let's just move to the next part, Neeraj. These are more technical in nature. If in case any one of you wants to connect again on a technical basis, we could just talk about it. Like I said, healthcare has been one of those areas which has been the single biggest R&D area. Since I have done a bit of work on this many years back, even a research at All India Institute of Medical Sciences, I can talk about it. So when somebody has a hand which is amputated, to even move one finger takes possibly many years of research and R&D to happen. Now, there are signals which get collated here from your motor muscles. And when you possibly put, in short, if in case somebody's hand is paralyzed, आपकी सोच के बेसिस पे बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट सिग्नल्स गो टू योर ब्रेन व्हेन यू मूव अ फिंगर आर बेसिकली प्री रिकॉर्डेड इन अ सिस्टम एंड देन व्हेन यू वांट टू एक्चुअली मूव योर फिंगर्स दोज प्री रिकॉर्डेड इंस्ट्रक्शंस गेट प्लेड ऑन टू दैट मशीन डिवाइस एंड दैट इनेबल्स यू टू मूव योर हैंड्स हेल्थ केयर हैज गॉन टू अनदर लेवल एंड करंटली पॉसिबली अनफॉर्चुनेट पार्ट ऑफ दिस पेंडेमिक or a fortunate part of this pandemic is the fact that healthcare spending is going to actually increase more, which is going to lead to possibly much better healthcare detection of these pandemics again in the future, way, way early than what happened right now, and how we can develop better quality medicines, which is going to happen. Whether it is in terms of your medical records, your previous medical history, your family medical history, the area in which you live in, what kind of toxins are typically released, whether it is in terms of sodium in the water or pollution levels in that particular area. All these are collated, tracked, data-driven, they are analyzed, and you can formulate much better use cases for better healthcare facilities over a period of time. Robots are currently used to do something called laparoscopic operations, plus also a lot of other areas in which automatic machines are helping, do all these areas, with more personalization in this area. Her individual ka kya area gap hai, क्या हेल्थ केयर में क्या प्रॉब्लम है उसके क्या हो सकती है क्या 5 साल में हो सकती है 7 साल में हो सकती है जेनेटिक कोडिंग के बेसिस पे व्हाट एजेस यू कैन टिपिकली फॉल इल बेस्ड ऑन दैट योर मेडिकल फैसिलिटीज योर इंश्योरेंस फैसिलिटीज कुड एक्चुअली बी कस्टमाइज्ड सो देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ डेटा डिटेक्शन गोइंग ऑन एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम वी कैन गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड नीरज नीरज कैन वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड BFSI, I see the fact that there are some people who are from the banking industry, like we spoke about the fact that there are some chatbots, there are a lot of these robots now in banks which help you collate information. And this information can typically be handy for doing a lot of redundant tasks, jo clerical level tasks hote hain, unko khatam kara ja sakta hai by the use of AI systems in banks as well. Now, there's a very small analysis that we have created just to understand where we are today and where we are looking at going forward from now. People are looking at different borrowing trends with banks. Kisko kiske hisab se borrowing chahiye? Somebody wants to plan for their children. You would have definitely heard of on how different kind and quality of insurance schemes are there. Jaise koi scheme ka naam hota hai ki your child goes to 18 years of age and then you get certain sum of money. That has been developed and driven using a lot of data analytics over a period of time. There's a very different field which is basically called actuarial sciences. There's a lot of hardcore number crunching which goes into defining what kind of policy premium you pay 18 साल की पॉलिसी के लिए मेच्योरिटी के लिए 10 साल की मेच्योरिटी के लिए बट डिपेंडिंग अपॉन हमारी जिंदगी में जो कंजम्पशन इकोनॉमिक्स आ गया है उसके बेसिस पे हमारी जो बैंकिंग और फाइनेंशियल नीड्स हैं वो भी जो दिन के हिसाब से चेंज हो रही हैं उनको हम कैसे केटर कर सकते हैं वेदर इट इज बाय द यूजेज ऑफ आप रियल टाइम इंश्योरेंस कैसे यूज करते हैं आप जैसे आज की डेट में कोविड को ऐड करना है आपके इंश्योरेंस में डिड योर इंश्योरेंस कंपनीज प्लान फॉर इट कैन दे ऐड इट इन योर सिस्टम्स कैन दे नॉट ऐड इट इन योर सिस्टम व्हाट काइंड ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजंस कैन यू मेक वंस द मार्केट हैज फॉलन डाउन टू द लेवल्स दैट इट हैज फॉलन डाउन टू हाउ कैन एल्गोरिथमिक ट्रेडिंग हेल्प यू मेक मनी इन द करंट सिस्टम्स आप लोग जो पुराना इक्विटी में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं वो इक्विटी की जो स्टैंडर्ड ट्रेडिशनल इन्वेस्टमेंट है वो समय के साथ कैसे चेंज हो सकती है आप लोग कैसे पैसा बना सकते हैं हाउ इज इट दैट यू डू नॉट लूज मनी डिस्पाइट द फैक्ट दैट द मार्केट्स हैव फॉलन डाउन बाय अबाउट 35% How do company reconciliations happen? Earning के ऊपर कैसे आप predictions बता सकते हैं कि इस महीने कितना आएगा, अगले महीने कितना आएगा? This market is going to go and see a seasonal downturn. Not that some of these people don't know it, but now machines can predict it far better than what humans can predict, because humans had a certain design and a way of predicting markets, marketing sentiments. There's a huge field of quantitative research which is helping make decisions on these areas, how payments get processed, when to get payments, how to maximize payments, how to remove payment frauds, what kind of security encryption algorithms are we using, how are we using something like cryptocurrency in terms of dealing and transacting on technology driven systems and stuff like that. Neeraj, can we move to the next slide? Now, like I said, marketing is possibly one of the single largest areas wherein we see the usage of artificial intelligence. You see, whether it is you are a business owner, you want to reach out to your target audience, or you are a consumer who wants the best quality, cheapest quality stuff, best quality stuff at the lowest price possible. So, wo kaise aayega? How does AI help you in profiling consumers? Profile kaise kara jata hai ek vyakti ko, uski spending habit kya hai? I'll give you a very simple example of the usage of AI. Now, somebody who has, so when we classify consumers under AI, now we do a lot of data collection. Bahut hi chota sa case hai, and that applies to every industry. Now, we can classify a person who typically buys and lives in traditional areas, somebody who is not a risk taker, somebody who likes to work in government organizations, somebody who is profiled, jiska stability bahut zyada hai. Maan lijiye koi banda ek saal ek hi company mein 5 saal 7 saal 10 saal 12 saal kaam karta hai, whether government or non government. Somebody stays in a traditional society, not in an upcoming condo. Now we classify that behavior as somebody who is not a great risk taker. Now you will typically not introduce a new product to this guy, you would typically not introduce a new society to this guy, you would typically not recommend a under construction property to this guy, because you would have classified under data classification, you would have categorized this guy as possibly not a very high risk taker. Aap isko high risk wale project recommend hi nahi karoge. Aap isko kabhi bhi wo, you will never fundamentally send him ads for very high risk projects. You're going to send him projects which are more stable in nature, which give a regular recurring return of about 6-7%. This kind of a person is not going to be interested in risking his money for a 20% return, which would come in 1 year or 2 years. Based on that, based on profiling behavior, we would typically classify our consumers, and we would look at lead generation, decision making, and you know, ad spending based on that as well. Yes, can we go to the next slide? I think we should rush into the HR slides more than anything. That is what seems to be the demand of the audience. Retail and e-commerce, I think you experience Amazon, Flipkart, a lot of other industries. As an industry, from a company perspective, कोई भी व्यक्ति आज के रेट में कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर डाल के अपना इन्वेंट्री में पैसा ब्लॉक नहीं करता है. Companies like to work on marketplace models, even though it comes costly to them. The reason is it helps them save the capital which is stuck up in inventory management. Now, even companies like Samsung, you know, Samsung releases at least about 40 models or more than 40-50 models in a year. They do not manufacture the entire stock in one go. They release a model, come out with certain anticipated number of pieces which have to go and hit the market. Jab wo bikna shuru ho jate hain, they understand the trend, ki where is the trend going, and then they manufacture more products in bulk. They also try to understand and close out what gaps, what colors, what sizes do consumers want. Now that's a very important part from a business perspective. From a consumer perspective, I understand that a lot of you are intelligent people. You do a lot of your analysis and you know, comparison and differentiation before buying and utilizing something. Neeraj, can we go to the next slide? So education, we have seen a lot of cases of education. Some of you may have children, some of you may be learning many things automatically all by yourself. We can have classifications, a very small use case that I can give you in a very simplistic languages. Agar maan lijiye aap logo ko sabko yaad hoga ek topic hai photosynthesis ka, ke ऑक्सीजन कैसे बनता है एक प्लांट में. उसके तीन एस्पेक्ट्स होते हैं. थ्योरी क्या है उसकी, व्हाट इज द थ्योरेटिकल डेफिनेशन ऑफ इट. सेकंड इज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग पार्ट ऑफ इट, वो होता है कैसे. थर्ड है उसका एप्लीकेशन कैसे होता है, हाउ डज फोटोसिंथेसिस अप्लाइज इन योर लाइफ. आप फोटोसिंथेसिस यूटिलाइज कैसे करते हैं कि गार्डन में जाएंगे ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट होगा तो आपकी सेहत बढ़ेगी. दैट इज एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इट. अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्या है, व्हाट इज द एग्जैक्ट प्रोसेस, व्हाट इज द साइंस बिहाइंड कन्वर्टिंग कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इनटू ऑक्सीजन, व्हाट इज द थ्योरेटिकल डेफिनेशन ऑफ इट. फोटोसिंथेसिस इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इनटू ऑक्सीजन यूजिंग सन एनर्जी और व्हाटएवर इट इज. ठीक है. नाउ From a learning perspective, you can actually identify the exact gap कि बच्चे में theoretical understanding में gap है, उसकी technical understanding में gap है, या उसको सब आता है लेकिन theoretical आता है, application बिल्कुल zero है उसका. आप उसको उसके हिसाब से सिखा सकते हैं. What are the areas in which you want to learn and grow yourself? We can move to the next slide, Neeraj. What are the other areas in which you can apply? Next slide again. How does e-learning work for you? How does e-learning not work for you? How companies categorize different stuff and things like that. These are basically how interconnection in terms of factories, how can you use AI and machine learning and IoT in your factories today. This is just one of those examples on how we have interconnected systems, machines which use sensors to basically detect the raw materials coming, going, packaging and everything else as well. We can just go to the next slide. Now, I will take time because I understand a lot of audience and this should have possibly been the start of the presentations. But having said that, like I said, in the initial stages, I will classify the application of AI in HR among three areas. आपकी selection में recruitment कैसे मदद करता है? ठीक है, पहला सिलेक्शन में कैसे मदद करता है रिक्रूटमेंट. सेकंड इज आप सिलेक्शन के अंदर दो पार्ट्स आ जाएंगे, बेसिकली हाउ डू यू फंडामेंटली क्लासिफाई कैंडिडेट्स. सेकंड इज हाउ डू यू इंटरव्यू कैंडिडेट्स. आप लोगों का इंटरव्यूज कैसे लेते हैं यूजिंग चैटबॉट्स और एडवांस चैटबॉट्स एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट. एंड द अदर एरियाज व्हिच टिपिकली कम इन इज क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज, व्हिच गाय इज गोइंग टू फिट इन इनटू व्हिच जॉब रोल. यू मे हैव हर्ड अ लॉट अबाउट इट. सबसे पहले उसका सीवी कैसे स्क्रीन होता है. सीवी स्क्रीनिंग जो आईबीएम ने वॉटसन के थ्रू, वॉटसन इज वन ऑफ द टूल्स दैट आईबीएम यूजेस फॉर स्क्रीनिंग सीवीज. व्हाट द नेम वॉटसन टू द एआई इंजन इज गिवन बेस्ड ऑन द फाउंडर एंड द लेगेसी ऑफ सीनियर वॉटसन एंड जूनियर वॉटसन इन आईबीएम, बट दैट इज द नेम ऑफ द एआई इंजन व्हिच इज गिवन टू आईबीएम. एंड अ लॉट ऑफ अदर कंपनीज आर आल्सो यूजिंग एआई फॉर स्क्रीनिंग द you know, the hundreds and millions of candidates which come and pass through their system. All the major popular companies do that. So classification of how CVs are screened. Second is classification from a skill perspective as well, as to which guy is going to fit into what kind of a role. How do you typically, what all you have been using in terms of psychometric analytics, how it has helped you and how it is going to not help you in terms of selecting the right candidate for the right job over a period of time. Profile augmentation, I mean, I'll just pick up all the four areas right now. The first part is, how do you search CVs based on meta tags, wo jo mota mota keyword based search hota hai. Keyword based basis ke basis pe aap vyakti ko classify kar lete hain. Lekin you cannot get the behavioral analysis of the guy or the social quotient of the guy for which you run AI algorithms in terms of understanding ki ek vyakti ka pura digital imprint kya hai. How has he fundamentally browsed the net? What kind of habits does he have when it comes to online digital presence? Twitter pe kis tarike ke comments? Does he have culturally extreme comments? Does he browse or typically post content which is objectionable, which is right wing or left wing by any kind? At a leadership level, what kind of maturity or lack of maturity has a person shown? Now, these things are not done in a manual fashion such that the decision would be influenced by the quality of the person who is searching this content. This is all done through using AI today. So when AI classifies the behavior in all these types and gives you a clear picture about where does a person fit in. Is he a leadership level person, not a leadership level person? Using AI, you typically use and reach to a lot of passive job seekers. How do you engage people over a period of time? You use a 5-stage cycle in terms of, first of all, identifying people. After identifying people, the second stage is typically about reaching out to them, wherein you would possibly talk about your employer branding. What kind of job branding do you have? What kind of job roles do you have? How do you classify different job roles? On job roles, what is the next level of growth which is going to happen? And so on and so forth. So that's the second stage which happens in terms of how do you classify these people. Then some of them may share an interest against an open position. Some of them may not share an interest in terms of an open position. Now, for those who share an interest against an open position, how do you fundamentally give them a wonderful experience in an automatic fashion? For those who don't, you keep sending them the case studies and what kind of career growth and where is your business going. Otherwise, at the last stage, stage number 5 is where you have physical interaction, whether on the phone or you invite them for events. A lot of international in the US or in the UK, a lot of events are organized once somebody has done through 4 or 5 stages of a digital engagement cycle for a large companies as good as a Facebook, Google as well. A person is finally invited in the last stage. Neeraj, can you go back one slide back as well before we go on to the next stage? So these are outreach programs. Chatbots are typically used. Intelligent chatbots can typically be used for taking not just HR interviews, but also a lot of technical interviews. Also, technical interviews are where it is very easy to take interviews. You would have seen a lot of old school assessment wherein questionnaire was given and people would typically give assessments over a questionnaire. The times have changed now. Assessment is typically the difficulty levels in the assessments can be changed. Resume screening, like I said, based on your job profiles. Resumes can be screened based on the keywords and understanding what the person has done, what kind of open source contribution has a person made, what kind of projects has the person done, and so forth. Can we move to the next slide fast? Natural language processing is like I was initially setting the context. NLP is possibly the single difficult problem that AI has solved. And this is what makes AI what it is today. So NLP basically helps in terms of classifying words, not just words. It also helps in classifying images and grammatical analysis coming out and having voice-based conversations is typically what some of the advanced machines can do. You can also do gamification. Gamification is currently used by companies as popular as Duolingo or a lot of language learning companies, which typically use some very, very applied artificial intelligence systems and patterns to create learning questions about you. How are you going to learn a language? How language is learned? Is it learned through objects? Is it learned largely through images? Is it learned through those card-based approaches? Is it learned through grammars? Is it learned majorly through just teaching you the keywords which are relevant to your industry? Say, if in case you have to learn, you have to work in a Japanese factory and you have to go to Japan for a period of 3 months or 6 months, what are the most important keywords that you should know? You're going to spend 3 months in Italy or Spain. What are the keywords? What are the most popular words, irrespective of your quality of grammar? Agar aap English ek pure smooth mein nahi bhi bol sakte, kya aap objects ko identify kar sakte, nahi kar sakte? A lot of these language learning companies use that kind of AI to teach you basic as well as advanced language. Facial and speech recognition algorithms typically help in understanding something called emotions. Emotions about a person are also being used as a very, very high area of application in countries like Singapore, US, a lot of European nations to understand whether you are happy in a company, whether you're not happy in a company. Now, there is a difference in face detection and face recognition as well as face classification. Face detection is a very advanced science. फेस को डिटेक्ट करना कि आप खुश हो खुश नहीं हो तो आपने एक प्री कंसीव पैटर्न्स बनाए हुए हैं टू अंडरस्टैंड वेदर समबडी इज हैप्पी व्हेन समबडी इज हैप्पी हाउ डज द फेस टिपिकली लुक लाइक तो द फिगर दैट यू सी टिपिकली गिव्स यू द एंगल्स इन विच योर हैप्पीनेस योर मूड स्विंग्स आर टिपिकली क्लासिफाइड बाय लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज अ लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज आर स्पेंडिंग अ लॉट ऑफ मनी ऑन द वेलबींग ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज हियर वी मूव ऑन टू द अदर स्लाइड्स एंड विल जस्ट फिनिश एंड टेक क्वेश्चंस this is an example of how an AI-driven HRMS system looks like. Now, fortunately, we have been working on such a system for the last 3 years. So as one of my companies, Rozgar HRMS, we typically use artificial intelligence in terms of face recognition. So I'll say, for example, the current problem that you have in a lot of companies is biometric pay attendance lagti hai. So we had done away with that problem long back only. We have both the options, the fingerprint as well as face recognition, but this is something that a lot of companies have appreciated of late, and we had done it possibly last year sometime only on how to do attendance based on facial recognition even at the gate as well as your individual data entry points. Similarly, how do you onboard people? Unka paperwork kaise hota hai? Unke paperwork pe classification kaise hoti hai? Where does a person belong? what all backgrounds is the person coming from. You can typically do leave and management analysis, payroll processing. How does the real-time tracking of people happen? A lot of people in the industry, at least about 70% people, at least 70% of people in the industry putting together the entire economy, work on wages. Wo daily ki dihadi pe kaam karte hain, whether it is construction, manufacturing, your farms pe kaam ho, ya fir aapki chai patti ke bagaan ho, bahut sara employment wahan pe bhi jata hai, bahut sare areas mein jata hai, shipping yards pe jata hai, bahut sare areas mein daily wages ka kaam jata hai. So based on your physical movement, do you have 100 people today in the factory? Do you have 100 people in the farm today? Do you have 100 people in the factory today? Unka leave and attendance usi ke hisab se, unki real-time tracking ke hisab se hota hai. Supply chain mein bada zaruri kaam hota hai. You know, not just the fact that your consignment has to be tracked. The human who has gone with the consignment also has to be tracked. So, using systems, we track the movement, most optimized route, the most optimized way of working, the most optimized expense. Ab aapki company mein 1000 log honge, koi vyakti 500 rupaye ka reimbursement file karta hai, koi 5000 ka reimbursement file karta hai. You can actually do an optimized number at what expense does one lead come for. That can help you create smarter expense management systems. You can obviously use a lot of chatbot driven help desk support in finding out grievances, handling grievances, creating predictive modeling strategies in terms of how to engage people, which employees are going to leave in how much time, stability kya rahegi ek employee ki, kaun se employees hain jo red zone mein hain, ye chhod sakte hain, nahi chhod sakte, inki performance kahan se kharab hona shuru hoti hai, kaise disengage hote hain. Now, once you have these insights, you can obviously create programs and modules to engage them. You want the machine to engage them directly, that can also happen. Vyakti ke task management ke hisab se, uska saal ka performance kaisa rahega, probable certain performance kaisa rahega, usko performance ko tweak karna hai, how can you do that? How can you increase, how can you do, the carrot and stick approach ke liye, you need a lot of data for data analytics. How does a carrot and stick approach work? Kis vyakti ko carrot dikhana hai, kis ko stick dikhana hai, system bata sakta hai. So you're basically your HR person ke vyakti vishesh ke upar aap na jaake, you can actually focus on data-driven analytics for taking those business decisions. We can move to the next slide. Cool. So we can come down to the question and answers. I think it would be really nice if in case we do question and answers on the group chat. I will take each and every group chat. I will just start from the top. I think 619. I'll just see if in case somebody has already sent questions. I think Nepal Singh has sent the first question at 6:30. How AI can help at bank counter services to customers, and to what extent it will impact on manpower planning, and also can AI help the employee working from work from home to service the customers of banking? Absolutely, Nepal Singh. The first thing is jo hum basic automated data collection karte hai. Now, what typically are bank counter services used for? Either somebody has gone to draw out cash, ya to koi vyakti cash nikalne jata hai bank mein, ya koi paisa jama karane jata hai. Now, these two are services which can totally be automated. You can just log in request from your mobile app. Somebody can come to your home to pick up money as well as drop money, which a lot of banks are using today. One. So that helps in work from home cases wherein this service has been extended out. This service may not have been extended out to a lot of retail customers, but this service has been there with all corporate customers since a long time. So that's one way of reducing counter services. I do not remember myself going to the bank counter for the last 7 years. Just to give you an idea about how my banking relationships have worked over a period of time. A lot of other cases also when people have to drop checks. So checks are dropped, their checks are cleared in that fashion. Checks are basically unki na image scan hoti hai. So it is not that banks, so today robots in the Western world, while they have very different ways of working, but just to give you a small use case, if in case you actually have a robot, like how HDFC has a robot to greet and to manage the counter services for walk-in customers, you can actually put in the check. चेक का पूरा स्कैन होके अंदर डिपॉजिट हो जाता है. चेक जो स्कैन होता है वो आपके मोबाइल पे या आपके ईमेल आईडी पे उसकी कॉपी जा सकती है. So that is one area. It is not a very difficult thing to do. If in case you are in the banking sector, you can consult us. We can help you design a system like this, which can help you, you know, make these image-based counter services can all be automated. Vipul has a question. In an industry, a lot of time and energy is spent on customer segmentation, creating a customer persona to improve order value or order frequency. How AI can help in understanding the customer better? Now, Vipul, this would typically depend from industry to industry, but this is the single largest use case for any industry. That is in terms of how do you classify customers. You would have some very good examples of companies like Salesforce.com, MS Dynamics, companies like these, which have typically done very advanced level expertise in terms of how do they classify customers, segment customers, manage the sales cycle over a period of time. It is largely done in B2B circles as compared to the B2C circles. But we see companies which are largely into e-commerce space like Amazon, Flipkart, companies like Google, which have companies like Facebook, companies like Instagram, which have done a very advanced level version of how they segment consumer behavior in terms of what kind and quality of videos do you like, what kind and quality of content do you like, what kind and content is a very large industry. Content is anything in the video form from Netflix to a lot of other forms as well, wherein companies make money. So when they classify you under different heads, they typically, they typically send you content. They engage you in a manner such that they increase more money that they can make out of you. You know, like you would have heard of your dopamine level increases when you use Facebook. You feel good about yourself when people like your post and so on and so forth. What kind of gamification do people use in gaming industry, video gaming industry? This customer segmentation is done. So if in case you can give me a particular industry of which you're looking at customer segmentation and customer persona, but everything starts from this. Everything starts in a B2B or a B2C industry. You classify ek customer ki buying power kitni hai, purchase power kitni hai, usko kya kya product and services pasand aate hain, usi ke basis pe hum ek sales cycle ko automate karte hain. Abhipsha has asked, what are the popular cases of AI in HR? Like I said, Abhipsha, the single biggest use case of AI. There are three major popular use cases of AI in HR. The first of all is screening of CVs through automated systems using AI systems like Watson and many other systems. Right now, you can actually create your own systems to screen CVs based on your specific rules that you want to screen CVs. So CV screening is one of the major areas in which AI is being used. The second area in which AI is being used is HR help desk. HR help desk help you in at least solving basic queries. Now, a lot of people call HR ki hamari leave policy kya hai, mere ko kitni chutti milegi, mere kitni chutti bachi hui hai, mera next holiday kab hai, mere ko chutti pe jana hai, I want to apply for a leave. All that stuff can typically be automated. Insurance policy kya hai. So you can send these people policies which they want in one shot. And that is one use case of AI in HR help desk. The other use case which is typically used and which is popular from an HR perspective is the emotional analysis, the emotional AI in companies which on which there has been a lot of work in terms of understanding the mood of people, where they are, where they are not, and stuff like that. Nepal Singh has also asked, how can AI be used for HR operations? Nepal Singh, HR operations typically starts from joining of a person. So joining of a person, that means all your documentation in terms of all your documentation can typically be uploaded, scanned using OMR sheets and advanced tools like TensorFlow as well. Aap symbols ko, icons ko, degrees ko padh sakte hain, unko classify karke database mein automatically dal sakte hain. Further classification of people can be done based on different roles, designations, and so on and so forth. So that can also be done. In HR operations, anything from joining to exit, typically everything is covered. If in case you want to make this term broader and cover payroll as well, all that stuff in terms of your PF, your ESI, your statutory obligation calculation, all that can automatically be calculated by the system. Your basic things like salary slips and basic documentation can all be automated. आपको ट्रैवल के लिए अप्लाई करना है, एक्सपेंस के लिए अप्लाई करना है, ऑल दैट बेसिक एचआर ऑपरेशंस ऑन एन एवरीडे बेसिस के ऑल ऑफ देम कैन बी ऑटोमेटेड. इसमें एआई कहाँ आता है, एआई इसको प्रिडिक्ट कर सकता है कि कितने लोग करेंगे. आप उसकी बजट प्लानिंग उसके हिसाब से कर सकते हैं, हाउ मच एक्सपेंस पर पर्सन इज गोइंग टू हैपन, हाउ मच टाइम पर पर्सन इज गोइंग टू हैपन, व्हाट आर द मोस्ट पॉपुलर क्वेश्चंस दैट पीपल यूज, एंड यू कैन यूज द सिस्टम टू ऑटोमेट ऑल दोस सेट ऑफ थिंग्स. सो इट हेल्प्स in helping you make your help desk smarter, your HR bot smarter over a period of time, so that without human intervention, what are the 80% cases which can totally be automated by the system. Shri Lipsa Raut has asked a question, how to use AI in HR function? Is there a course or way through which you can learn AI for HR? Now there are, I think we have discussed about many applications of AI in HR functions. There are obviously other applications of AI in other HR functions as well. When it comes to engagement, even a survey form, जैसे आप अपनी companies में survey form भरवाते हैं, how many people are actually filling in the survey form, how many people are not filling in the survey form, that also talks about the engagement levels in the company, what is the stability of employees in the company, what is the non-stability of employees, how much particular appraisal do you need to give to people for keeping them hooked onto the systems and so on and so forth. We will move to the next. You can do courses on AI. I would advise you, you can actually look at how the first course that you should ideally start from is data analytics. So you can start from the usage of data analytics and statistics in HR before moving on to any advanced courses in AI. Some of the use cases of HR industry, AI chatbot for interviews. Okay, I'll move to the next one. Leverage AI to attract, screen, engage, and hire the best employees. Performance management. A message from Value Innovation Labs. Okay, so that's my company. I think Vishali from my company would have already answered this question, tried to put some use cases. Performance management mein aap AI ka istemal kar sakte hain, HR analytics mein istemal kar sakte hain, employee churn mein kar sakte hain. Himanshu Gupta has asked a question, AI, we can use it in almost every walk of life. You can suggest as a beginner, how should I start learning AI? Himanshu, my suggestion to you would be, if in case you're around, your first suggestion should be, you should start from data analytics, data utilization, statistics, understand where and what basic automation do you need. So based on whatever job function that you are in, what industries you are in, you could typically start from there. Vipul, I am looking for e-com. So Vipul, if in case you can detail out that question, that would help. Jitender has asked, AI roles will make life easy and simple for consumer, educated and uneducated, reading consumer behavior and interest, cost effective and fast process. Jitender, that's a wonderful input. I think since digital, you also work in the digital business, you would possibly be, as a consumer and as a creator of AI solutions, I think you have put it right. The biggest application of AI is for a lot of people who are uneducated, and consumer behavior and interest ke basis pe, you know, our lives are made more happier, more easier over a period of time. Nepal Singh has asked a question, sir, certainly it's possible, how consumers of villages, old pensioners, government schemes, how AI can help public sector bank to manage these customers and branch offices. Nepal Singh, these are very, very good examples of about what you have spoken about. Like I said, NLP, natural language processing, voice ke through aap instruction de sakte hain, aap voice messages record karke de dijiye and bankers can act on it. So jo customers hain, I mean, unfortunately in India, to every 30 villages, we have only one bank branch when it comes to PSU bank branches. And it's a very difficult problem. People walk and travel almost about 10-15 kilometers before they reach places. Hence, there are a lot of collection centers that PSU banks have created across multiple villages, wherein they collect their checks, they collect deposits and stuff like that. Government schemes are typically pura ka pura DBT ho gaya, direct benefit transfer ho gaya, Nepal Singh. Your Jandhan is possibly the single biggest example of how government has reached out even to migrant workers, including giving them, whether it is 1,000 rupees or 500 rupees or 2,000 rupees for traveling support or for food support in the current times. Based on unification of all data using Aadhaar, government schemes are currently being given. In fact, I was amazed at how Government of India currently, there is a website, I can just put up a link. Neeraj, if in case you can put up the link of that website. So you can go to this website, you can check about eligibility that anybody has. So you can typically put about your caste, your area, your age, your gender, if in case somebody is physically handicapped, not handicapped, and you can get a list of all the schemes that are applicable to you or not. Obviously, there's a long way that AI can be used in these areas because AI is not smart. These schemes may apply to some people, they may not apply to some people. Like everybody doesn't need a mudra loan. But who needs a mudra loan? Can it be pre-provided to that person? Can there be a pre-approval to that, to a person who is running a smaller business by his tax filing and so on and so forth? Jitender has answered, AI majorly uses robotic technology, which is great. Neeraj has also answered, apart from robotic, AI can typically be used for managing patient customers. Predictive modeling can be used by a lot of pharma companies. Now, Harshvardhan has written a question, I'm arranging cultivation of herbs in Uttarakhand hills from August 2020. How we can use AI in this process and how it's progressing without physically visiting every farmer, how it could help us prediction of supplies to our pharma manufacturers. That's a very, very good question, Harshvardhan. This is already happening. There are a lot of agri-tech companies which typically are already working on soil research. There are different, based on different soil research, you can understand which crops are best suited for which soil, what time of the year. Using weather predictions, farmers can actually be told 15 days in advance, 1 month in advance, 3 months in advance, what exactly is it, is the season likely going to happen. Based on your cultivation, you can actually account for the fact that aapka pauda kitna lamba ho gaya hai, uski maturity kitne height pe aati hai, uske hisab se aap apna inventory प्री प्लान कर सकते हैं, आप अपनी लेबर को प्री प्लान कर सकते हैं कि आपको लेबर कौन से महीने में कितने दिनों तक की जरूरत होगी. टिपिकल मोटा मोटा ड्रोन्स के थ्रू उनकी मॉनिटरिंग हो सकती है पूरी की पूरी. मोटा मोटा आप कितने दिनों में कितना फसल पैदा होगा और उसके बेसिस पे आप प्री ऑर्डर बुकिंग कर सकते हैं मार्केट के अंदर, वेदर इट इज़ फॉर मार्केट प्लेस सेल और फॉर यू नो यू आर डायरेक्टली लुकिंग टू सेल इट टू मैन्युफैक्चरर्स एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ. I think we've just exceeded our time by about 10 minutes. If in case somebody has any last question, we could just take it. Otherwise, I think you can easily reach out to us with the contact details that we will provide. Harshvardhan, the cost of making use of these technologies, some of these technologies are provided free of cost by a few agriculture technology incubators which Government of India runs. Pusa Krishi runs an incubator like that. Government Ministry of Agriculture runs a few incubators. I'm aware of another incubator called Indigram, which is run by Ministry of Rural Development. It has an annual funding of about 3,000 crores, which typically works in this area of agri-tech. So I think, Shefali, we are typically done unless somebody has a specific question.
I think, Kunal, you have answered all the questions very well, and the presentation which you gave was self-explanatory. I mean, it covered all the industries, the pharma, the healthcare, the banking, the HR vertical, retail sector, all manufacturing, all the sectors we have already covered. And I have asked the audience also one-on-one also. So I don't think they are left with any of the questions. So I believe it was a great insightful session for a lot of us, and even for me also. I mean, I normally related AI with HRMS, but yes, we can do so much with technology with AI. That's honestly an eye-opener for me also today. So I would request all of the people that thank you so much for joining us today. What we'll be doing is we'll be sharing the YouTube link of the today's session at your respective email IDs, and we'll be sharing the contacts also of Value Innovation Labs, Vaishali, and other people also, in case you want to know more something about these sessions, about the platform, about the services, how we can. You can always get connected one-on-one with all of them. So I'm glad you all of are here. Thank you so much, Kunal, for joining us and for this wonderful session.
Thank you so
session.
Much. And I would also like to take a moment to really thank and appreciate all of you. You know, what happens is the flow of presentation is typically not customized to one person. It is customized to a generic audience. Some people are happy with it. Some people are not so happy with it. You know, ultimately, there is something in it for everybody across industries. If in case we do not understand the implication of where AI impacts us in e-commerce, we can't be great consumers of it, even though we might just be producers of AI for HR or for marketing or for manufacturing areas. Similarly, as a consumer in marketing or as an enterprise in marketing, it is completely extremely important to understand how do people in the manufacturing industry get impacted by using AI as a use case in people management. And so is the case in logistics, in how our stuff travels. आप उसकी cost कैसे reduce कर सकते हो? जो आपके पास PNG के products आते हैं, cream आती है, cosmetics आता है, उसकी cost पर किलोमीटर कैसे कम होती आ रही है और होती आएगी, और उसकी पर्सनलाइजेशन कैसे होती है? देयर आर सम प्रोडक्ट्स, यू नो, गुड प्रोडक्ट्स, से फॉर एग्जांपल यू लाइक समथिंग, यू हैव टेस्ट टुवर्ड पैनकेक्स और वॉफल्स, एंड यू नो यू वांट टू बाय दोस टोस्टर्स, हाउ कैन पर्सनलाइजेशन हैपन बेस्ड ऑन व्हाटएवर यू वुड लाइक, व्हेन यू वुड लाइक, उसके प्राइस पॉइंट्स सही रहे आपके लिए और क्या क्वालिटी मिले. हर चीज में आए, आपके खाने की हैबिट में, रेस्टोरेंट्स में, रेस्टोरेंट्स कैसे आपको डिस्काउंट करते हैं. तो इट्स नाइस टू हैव जनरिक इन्फॉर्मेशन एज वेल एज अ गुड यूज केस. आपको यू नेवर नो वेयर यू कैन स्ट्राइक अ गुड यूज केस फॉर योर ओन इंडस्ट्री. बट मेनी थैंक्स फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस टुडे एंड हैव अ वंडरफुल इवनिंग. होप टू सी यू ऑल सून अगेन. थैंक यू
सो मच कुणाल, एंड थैंक यू वंडरफुल ऑडियंस. थैंक यू सो मच.